Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome to Mass Effect. In the last part, we took care of some geth and we got introduced to husks, and we also got a new crew member. Isn't that right, Ashley?
Let's get the bastards.
Couldn't agree with you more. Let's go! This part, we're probably gonna make it to the spaceport and we're gonna deal with more geth on the way. Because, well, geth are assholes. But first, what's this? Nihilus.
Saren. Nihilus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Turn around! Holy shizneck! That is the most oversized squid I have ever seen. It kind of looks like a squid, don't you think? Well, at least it confirms something. It's not a giant hand like I originally thought. And I'm under attack by geth again. Okay. I wonder if I can reach this far away and hit him. Answer? Yes! You can use biox for extreme distances and really set them off. Obviously, I would consider the geth to be a big, the bigger threat, but don't really have to worry about them right now. Speaking of zombie, what do you guys think of that whole zombie apocalypse story that came out like a couple months ago? Remember hearing about that? Someone claimed that the world would be destroyed by a zombie apocalypse. I just thought it was just some dumb shit. I mean,
everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out, we're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. I knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only, it was coming from inside your own head.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to
think.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
If there's something you're not telling me.
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
You greedy bastard. You weren't running for your life. You were running to check on your merchandise.
No, it's not like that. I just knew there were some packages here. Something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
Or you can get more stuff if you have what the Charmer Intimidate up.
We're risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that could help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably deserve it more than I do.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
He might have something to do with this whole attack, Cole. We need his name. It's important.
Yeah, okay, you're right. His name's Powell. Works the docks at the spaceport, if he's still alive.
I have to go.
Good luck.
So if you did that, you get the Stinger 2, which is an extremely powerful pistol, definitely worth taking along. And the combat sensor, which, well, to explain it, geth use jamming signals sometimes. So you notice that radar I've been using? Well, sometimes it'll be jammed because of an influx of geth. Combat sensor supposedly works around it, but I never found much of a use for it. Stinger 2, on the other hand, is absurdly powerful. Let me compare it. How is that? I give it to myself. Because I'm a greedy bastard like that. And I was saying, remember that zombie apocalypse thing a while back? I mean, what the hell was that about, really? The entire world's gonna be overrun by zombies? Ah, here's the electronics thing I was telling you about. It's because I don't have somebody that's that knows electronics. And what do you guys think about that? That was one of the dumbest things I've ever heard. We are gonna be overrun by zombies. Now, first off, I don't believe in all these doomsday, all the doomsday crap. The only thing I know is, relatively speaking, I'm going to die, we are all going to die, but I prefer living my life on my own terms and not letting some apocalyptic bullshit,
Commander, it's Nihlus,
decide my life for me, or control the way I live my life. Radioactive rounds, just poisoning crap, you don't need it. I don't use too much of this stuff, like I said, it's, most of it's kind of useless.
Something's moving, over behind those crates.
Wait, don't,
Powell.
Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
What are you doing sneaking around back there?
I'm sorry, I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
What the hell are you talking about?
There were two Turians here, your friend and another one he called Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
Where'd Saren go after he killed Nihlus?
He jumped on the cargo train and headed over to the other platform. Probably going after the beacon. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone! If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too!
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
Why not? I'm lazy. Nothing wrong with being lazy, dude.
If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch! We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Forget about him. He's not worth it.
You're lucky the commander's here, pal. Hand over those grenades.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
Jeez, Ashley is such a fucking hard ass.
A lot of Marines died here, Powell. Those grenades could have come in handy. If I were you, I'd think of some way to make it up to them.
Yeah, okay. There is something else I was saving. Could be worth a fortune. Experimental technology, top of the line. Take it. I don't need it. I didn't want anyone to get hurt. Really, I'm sorry.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
A ship that can make the sky turn black? That is a badass entrance. I don't care what you say.
Tell me about the geth attack.
It was quick. 1 minute that ship was descending, the next, those geth were swarming over the platform. Thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
High explosive one. All right, I can use that. High explosive just basically makes your grenades explode in a larger radius. Also causes more damage, which is nice. Personally, it's the only one I ever use. And you get 5 grenades, wow. But like I said, I really don't like grenades that much. I like this music right here, but the thing about Mass Effect, which is kind of interesting with the music, they'll recycle it, but it'll sound different every time. They'll kind of remix it a little bit, I guess you could say, but there's a bunch of times where they'll use the same bit of music beat and just, you know, tweak it a little bit. One of my favorite track is actually kind of remixed off another track. Oddly enough. More geth. See if I can hit him. Don't think I did. Okay, get ready for a little bit of a firefight here. It's not big yet. They're not gonna... Ooh, plasma containment cell. If you have someone with overload, or you just want to blow them up to be a douche nozzle, not a bad idea. Because that happens! Although I had nothing to do with that, personally. But I'm glad I mentioned it now. What we got? Geth destroyer, oh shit. Geth destroyers are basically close-range enemies, I believe. Believe they have shotguns. Makes them kind of powerful, so you want to be careful get around these guys. And I'm going to lose Caden very soon. And for some reason... There we go. For some reason, Shepard went out of cover for no reason. And Caden's about to die, unless I do something. Good. Now, don't worry about those barriers, you can just shoot them with your gun and it'll probably cause more damage. There we go. I wonder if I could hit through the thing. Answer? No. Worth a try though. There we go. Now when you're using the radar... Damn it, don't pop up on me. Sorry about that. One of my security things on the computer decided to pop up. When you see an exclamation point on the map, or the radar, that means, well... Objective. We're good running at 15 minutes.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
So it appears that Saren is in cahoots with the geth. What the? So Saren is in cahoots with the geth, so we can find this motherfucker Saren. Try to bring him to justice. But it appears we got other trouble. Another thing you want to be careful of, you notice Caden was very low on health. You don't want them to die. Yet. Or you really don't want them to lose all their health, because then they die.
Demolition charges.
First, I gotta take care of this.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down!
Be careful when you do them, obviously, because you're left fully vulnerable. But when they lose their health, the only way to bring them back is with a power called Unity. I don't have that power yet, so if Caden goes down, I can't do shit about it. And like everything else, the metagel thing takes time to recharge as well, so you really want to be careful. Caden, please take care of him. Thank you. Thank goodness most of the geth can't stand a simple throw attack. Oh, shock trooper! They're an upgraded version of our friend, the geth trooper. And I almost just shot it. Oh shit! Sniper! Sniper! Don't want sniper! Hey, snipers! Oh, I'm gonna die fucking very soon! Man. I almost died there. That would have sucked. I did die. Well, you just saw what happens when you suck up the place and you decide to act like a dumbass. You die. Maybe I should have practiced on veteran before I actually did this on veteran. That was stupid of me, though. I shouldn't have gone out into cover, out of cover like that. That was a
demolition charges. The geth must
very idiotic idea.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
Because I was saying about Unity, I don't have the power yet. So if you lose somebody, the only way for them to come back is to finish off the battle. Whatever battle you're in, if you're in like a certain room with like five enemies, you have to kill them all. Then they'll revive with about a sixth of their health, an eighth of their health. Not much health at all. But hey, you get him back at least. I mean, that should be good enough for something, right? And if I can find that fucking sniper, I'll make sure he pays the price. God damn, why are grenades so weak? Oh, got him! Nice! Hey! Damn you. Great, I lost Caden. Which means now I gotta practice what I preach. Sniper, I gotta take care of the sniper. There we go, sniper taken care of. Now I gotta find some way around this bullshit. I'm dead. Damn it! You know what? Remember I said I kept using the shotgun? Well, I'm not gonna use it anymore. I'm gonna be using the pistol for this one. Why, you ask? Well,
demolition charge.
Oh, there's a reason. If you hold the L left bumper, you can get to see what thing you can use. So I'm gonna use this. It'll allow me at least a little bit of flexibility in terms of combat. Because there is a power that I picked up called Marksman. And what this power is gonna do, well, just wait. Just watch. I probably won't blow everything out of the water. I don't plan to, but I'll at least cause a bit of impact. It basically turns you into a madman. Your bullets become so much more powerful. And to top it all off... Oh. Geth. Top it all off, it's very... To top it all off, your bullets become just much more powerful and you rarely will overheat your weapon. And that's a shock trooper. He's down. Pistol's actually not bad. You know, I've used it a lot. When I first played the game, I played as an infiltrator. That was when I, you know, before I learned that the sniper rifle sucked ass. I learned that the pistol was actually a very, very good weapon. What else would be good is if I pay attention to the geth guy right there. There we go. I leveled up, yay! But we'll take care of that in a little bit. For right now, we got more pressing concerns. Like, namely, this demolition charge right here. Okay, good. One more. Zero more! You really don't have to worry about the timer. They gave you 5 minutes, which is plenty of time to do this. So now we don't have to worry about the charges, which is wonderful. But we still don't have Kaden because, well, yeah. Yeah, if I used a metal gel right now, he would not come back. Also, when you fight certain enemies, geth being one of them, and a lot of mechanicals actually, they'll give you equipment every time you kill them. Case in point, radioactive rounds. Most of it's useless, but just something I point out. Turian armor and Turian armor. One's from Hank Eater, one's from Devlin. I guess I'll keep them both and see which one's actually better. I got some creds for it too, nice. Uh-oh. You hear that? That should take care of him. Doesn't sound good. Uh-oh. Who's this guy? Zombie! 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 Get out of my way! No! No! Eat shotgun, scum! Not for nothing, but when I heard about the zombie apocalypse, I said, you know what's gonna... Ah, damn it. Not good. I basically said, if that's the case, then the sales for shotguns are gonna go up, because everybody... Every game you see, like Left 4 Dead and all them, that use zombies, people have shotguns. Distinguished Service Medal. I don't know what I did to get it, but I did something. And you notice now Kaden is revived, but still pretty weak. Without a shield as well, I might add. Not worth it. Not worth it. So let's check out this beacon. When you see an X on the radar, that means that you're near a critical point or like another objective or something. Kind of like the exclamation point, but it's kind of the same thing. And we see flags that are like marked locations on your map.
Normandy, the beacon
is
secure.
Amazing. Request immediate actual email. Working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Uh-oh.
Shepard!
No, don't touch him! It's too dangerous!
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
I think Saren hates me. Just a guess. Well, with the mission now pretty much complete. Hold on.
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Dumb bitch.
Where's the beacon now? What happened to it?
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
Chief Williams isn't part of the Normandy crew.
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Alenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren. That other Turian. Saren's a specter. One of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how, I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
Great. Politicians? We're gonna need politicians' support on a very important task. After seeing what the U.S. Congress has been doing, I really don't like this idea.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his Spectre status.
I'll contact the Ambassador.
Political bullshit.
See if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
I'll spare you guys the sermon. If you've guys watched my Let's Plays before, you know I really have no love lost for politicians. But, yeah. So, this is where I'm going to end this part. Next time, Mass Effect, well, we talk to a crew for the first time, man. We head to the Citadel to talk with, politicians. So, 40 Warriors signing off.